Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Nahid Riya Islam, Senior Consultant Psychiatrist, GNRC Dispur, Guwahati. Today I'm going to talk upon World Mental Health Day, which is celebrated worldwide as a part of the efforts to promote mental health awareness among the general public. It is celebrated on the 10th of October every year. This year, the theme has been kept at suicide prevention. Suicide in recent times have assumed great importance and the rates of suicide has increased considerably. Almost 8 lakh people commit suicide and lose their lives every year all over the world, and which accounts for almost one death every 40 seconds by suicide, which is quite an alarming figure. Suicide has evolved into a major public health problem nowadays, and it is seen to occur across all lifespan of an individual, and the rates of suicide among the youth has particularly increased in recent times. In fact, it is the second leading cause of death among young people between 15 to 29 years old. In some cases, suicide is seen to occur as an impulsive act by an individual following some kind of stressful event, and the person may not have showed any previous symptoms of depression. And this is more commonly seen in young people, especially people who have low frustration tolerance, who are easily excited, who have poor coping skills, and often tend to have mood swings. Usually in younger people, suicide is seen to occur because of academic stress. It could be because of parental pressure or parental expectations, failure to achieve, or relationship problems, rejection, and so on. In middle-aged people, causes may be the same, but there could be work stress, there could be financial problems, financial crisis, or relationship problems, marital problems. In elderly people, more commonly, suicide may happen because of feelings of isolation, feelings of loneliness or abandonment by family members, or it could be because of the burden of physical illness, chronic physical problems, for which the person may have depression and eventually commit such an act. Suicide can happen due to a large number of causes. Most likely it's because of depression, which the person suffers but which is not diagnosed and can lead to this unfortunate consequence. There can be many other causes for suicide, like psychotic problems, or a most common association is substance abuse. Then in very few cases it could be because of intense anxiety of the individual, and many other such causes. In India, the rates of suicide have also increased, and it's almost 16 per 10 lakh population, and the male is to female ratio is almost 3:1. Many countries have adopted suicide prevention strategies, and it's very important that all countries should adopt an active suicide prevention strategy to avoid this kind of tragedies happening. One of the most important causes of suicide, which I've already mentioned, is depression. So it is very important that people know what is depression and how to diagnose it at the earliest, or how to detect it at the earliest among their loved ones or in them as well. Depression is a mental health condition which is characterized by low mood, lack of pleasure, sleep disturbances, appetite loss, and a lack of energy level, or a feeling of sadness which is there all the time. Usually it may happen following some kind of stress in an individual's life, and if it persists for more than 2 weeks, we have to label it as clinical depression. In a depressed state, people often feel very helpless, they feel hopeless, and they feel worthless at times. And when the depression is severe, it often culminates in feelings like life is not worth living for, and it's better to die than live like this. And this is how suicidal ideation is produced in an individual. And when an individual or a particular family member or friend or colleague talks about dying or talks about committing suicide, it is very important that it is to be taken seriously, and he or she should immediately brought for mental health evaluation. People should be aware of such symptoms happening in their loved ones, and should not ignore or should not neglect it for some kind of stigma which a lot of people have regarding mental health issues. Because just like any physical condition, mental health issues are also the same. And people should come out in case they are suffering from such symptoms. Basically, suicide prevention can be done by early identification of such people who are prone to such kind of mental health problems and proper evaluation and treatment of the individuals. Also, government has certain responsibilities, as I've already mentioned about the suicide prevention strategies. And usually the World Health Organization has laid emphasis upon certain strategies like reducing the means or reducing the access to those means of suicide, like controlling pesticides or supply of pesticides only to registered farmers or people, so that anyone and everyone can't lay their hands on such means of suicide. Also, at the same time, the media should be taught how to responsibly portray suicide or mental health issues in the social front or the media front. And it's very important to impart life skill education to young people and to promote their coping skills and how to handle life's adversities with perseverance and patience. There is a life skills program curriculum in schools, but it is yet to be implemented universally across all schools in the world, and the government should look into this urgently so as to improve the young population's perseverance or resilience to adverse life events. Also, proper monitoring of such patients and as well as surveillance of suicide statistics is important. And one thing I would like to add is, when a person has attempted suicide before, it's a very strong indicator that there's a chance there might be repetition of the act, and therefore these people should be regularly evaluated for any kind of problems or brought to mental health professional if at all such symptoms do show up again. A previous attempted suicide is also a very strong indicator that there might be repetition of the act. And so it is very important that such people be regularly followed up for any kind of emerging mental health issues. With this, I'd like to conclude at the end that suicide is preventable with proper treatment and identification of problems in the individual. And people, particularly family members, family friends, colleagues, should be aware of such problems happening in their near and dear ones. And there should not be any hesitation in bringing the individual for a mental health evaluation, so that prompt identification of the problems can be done and such unfortunate consequences prevented. And also, I would like to request, or also I would like to make an appeal to the government to lay emphasis and promote mental health among the population. Thank you.